What's up, friends of the good mood? It's Manny, and welcome to some trolling action right here. Behemoth with 3x overdrive, 4x maxed Chimera, absolute trolling yummy goodness. Let's have some fun. See over there, there's a Bulgazari shooting us right there with Pulsar, and we're hammering into his flank from the left side where his shield is not existent. And I want to take some damage so I can start using the overdrive, right? There is a Spectre. Take a look at that Spectre. He's just getting hit by one salvo now. And rup. Oh, he's okay. He's in safety, but this one will come in from the other side. Rup. Did you see that? Dude, the guy just got one hit and he almost lost his robot from these four Chimeras at max damage, right? With overdrive rocket. Now, you could technically increase the damage further by using some kind of module, like, for example, using Deathmark module and the drone that will activate another 75% damage whenever you use an active module. That would be another 100% damage. That Spectre would have literally been a one-hit kill if I had done that, but I thought maybe I need that phase shift to stay alive, right? Look how much damage they're getting. Look at this. Okay, he just activated Leech ability, so he's no longer taking the damage, but the first hit, he lost half his robot, and I don't need line of sight with this, so I can just troll away right here at the enemy, and trying to finish him off right now, but I think he's probably safe around this corner. Let's go at whatever this is, firing at me there. Boom, 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 boom. Whoa! That was just one out of three shots, and he loses almost the entire robot right there. From those four Chimeras. The Behemoth offers the highest firepower in the game aside from Titans. Without needing line of sight on those weapons, that is really fun. That is really crazy. Alright, so we have a Scorpion that already jumped somewhere. I'm not quite sure where he jumped, but I need to get away from here. You see, I have a lot of health, still 180,000 health. Thankfully, the Behemoth is not something you can kill easily. But while walking away, I'm shooting at that Aochun, see that? And, unfolding, and here we go. Boop, there he is, done. And another phase shift triggered, see that? I constantly have to use that phase shift. If I didn't have the phase shift, I would constantly be locked down and then killed by Pulsar, or by whatever else they are shooting at me, right? And I wouldn't be able to deactivate the lockdown and just get myself in safety. So, while it would be more interesting, technically, to have more firepower, like 100% more firepower with a damage active module drone and the death mark, at the same time, I would probably already be dead at this point, right? And you see there's a Nightingale to my right. So, that's something that will happen a lot. People just coming for you, right? This is something that happens a lot, that people simply come for you. You hit them once or twice with those weapons, and it won't take long for them to go up and get right in your face because they hate those weapons. They hate Hydras. They hate Chimera. And they hate the very fact that you are still alive in the game once you hit them once with those weapons. So there's going to be a lot of focus that comes for you, again, which is the reason why I think phase shift just does very well. Now, he was smart. He stand behind the wall right there. Couldn't finish him off, but oh, there's a Scorpion right there in front of us. Thankfully, this guy is not going for me, but he's running right through our team, and let's just hit one button, and then, rup, gotten the kill. And also this guy, yep, firing at him, and wow, everybody was firing at him. That was not the best. And again, see, I would be locked and probably killed right here if it wasn't for the phase shift being ready, so that really is the only way to do this. Unless maybe you're playing on Moon or something, where the enemy doesn't really have a line of sight with you, and you can just constantly hit the enemy. Now, let's fire at a Titan in the air. With the overdrive, see, even the Titan takes some good damage. It's actually damage that he shouldn't be neglecting, right? Because over time, that will add up to a dead Titan right there if I hit him a couple of times like this. Problem is that so many enemies have resistance, so many enemies have stealth, so many enemies have phase shift, and so many enemies have the ability to do something that will deactivate, basically, your firepower. See, this guy right there is leeching now, so if the last stand wouldn't have been there, I would still not have killed him. And I would have probably damaged myself. So, I'm trying to stay safe behind this bridge from the Titans, and fire at whatever I can find here. And guys, if you like the content, here using some outside-the-box setups like the Chimera Behemoth, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet, guys. This is trolling level 1000 right here. This is as trollish as it gets. It's even more devastating than the Hydra Spectre or Hydra Leech or whatever, because Chimeras do even more damage than Hydras do, and that's four times on the Behemoth, right? Unfortunately, I don't know where he was. I couldn't really hit him all the way, but some of my shots went through and just damaged him really good, badly. We are currently in the lead, so my team is currently doing a good job. And that allows me basically to just do this. Here we have a Nodens. So I'm now firing at the Nodens right there, sending those homing bombs at him the whole time. And yeah, hurting him. Really good, actually. Man, but the thing is, here's something I gotta be honest with you guys about. I had to record a lot of videos in order to get one match recorded that was actually good, right? Because most of the time, what will happen if you play this setup, a Scorpion will simply tell himself, you know what, that Chimera Behemoth needs to die. So the Scorpion will just jump you and kill you, and then he teleports back. Boom, finished. And that's it, that was your Chimera Behemoth. And that's something that will happen a lot, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you. I had to record a lot of videos just to get one really good match out. And that's very unfortunate, because it just shows that Behemoth is not a viable robot in the game. It will just be killed. It will just be killed no matter what by jumping Scorpions, by maybe some other things that, like, Vortex setups that just jump stealth and then hit you once from above. Things like that, and you're just going to lose that Behemoth, and there's just nothing you can do about it because, well, turns out you have no defensive abilities on this thing. On the contrary, your ability makes you even immobile, so you can no longer even walk. Which makes me wonder, why in God's name has there not been a legendary pilot included into the game that allows the Behemoth to actually be a viable sniper setup that can have some kind of defensive ability also when being deployed. Giving him 40% resistance or so when he is deployed and allowing him to use his four heavy weapons on the move. That would be very important. Allowing him to move with his weapons rolling, so you don't have to screw yourself and make yourself immobile against potential threats every time you want to do what you're supposed to do, fire with your maximum fireball, right? You got no resistance, you got no jump, you got no shield, you got nothing. All you've got is four heavy weapons that are only usable when you're stationary. And that may have been a good robot back in the days, but it's no longer with Scorpions and Hawks that just laser you from halfway across the map. It's no longer viable. It doesn't work anymore. So if you want the Behemoth to actually be something useful in the game, then you've got to give it a legendary pilot that will do two things. And then it will become a useful setup again. Two things: resistance when deployed and using all four weapons undeployed. And then the Behemoth would actually be a very interesting setup. It would finally be a better Fury, and it would finally be a, something I would probably run from time to time, because it would be fun to do so. I'm spreading my firepower up as best as I can here to try and get the most kills, to try and get the highest damage into the enemy team. And at the end of the match, you're also going to see some stats about how much damage I was in the end actually able to do. Because you see, this is actually a really good match. Something that, again, happens very rarely. Most of the time, this stuff happens. You fire a salvo at an Aochon and he gets to fly before the rockets hit, and there goes your rockets. They will no longer score any hits because he entered stealth. And it's stealth, it's teleport, it's resistance, it's shields, it's all of that, right? That basically make these Chimeras next to worthless. Now he's phase shifting, yeah. So, next thing. First he had stealth, then he had phase shift. That's now 30 seconds of no damage coming in on him. 30 seconds of no damage coming in. Just because of those two things that he used. Now if I had fired at him, he would have had another stealth, right? Saw this? The stealth came up. If I had fired at him, he would have again been invincible from my rocket. So, just 90% of the time, you're just not going to do any damage with those old weapons. And the thing is, those aren't even old weapons. Chimera are not even old weapons. Those are relatively up to date. It's just an old style or type of weapons that are being used. Now we're getting taken down and my team is now losing. You see, they're dropping out of the match. I have only one weapon left. So jumping into the Titan here real quick, but the match is over anyway, so that's it. Let's see how much damage this was. This gave me an opportunity to explain to Pixonic and you guys out there what the Behemoth would need to actually be a setup that people would enjoy running from time to time. Because as a sniper on Springfield with Gauss Trebuchet or maybe with the Flux, that's something you can maybe do from afar away, but there aren't just sniper maps in the game, and you probably want to also be able to use that Behemoth somewhere on Dead City. You want to be able to use that robot somewhere on Castle or so, without risking to be locked and instantly killed every single time you deploy, and you don't get the necessary mobility to get back yourself into cover, right? But yeah, so you see we have done 2.8 million damage. That's actually the highest damage done in my team. From a Behemoth Chimera, but again, I had to record like 8 videos just to get one good match, okay? So don't consider this to be a useful and viable setup, and don't spend your resources building that, because it's not going to be fun. You will have 1 out of 10 matches that is fun, and then you have 9 out of 10 matches where a Scorpion just jump kills you and there's nothing you can do about it. Because those weapons, believe it or not, if somebody stands right in front of you, you can't hit them. You cannot hit them. Those weapons cannot even score a hit. They will just not hit if the people stand right in front of you. Another really ridiculous thing. But yeah, still some trolling that I wanted to show you guys. So thanks for watching. Have a good one. And until next time, Manny signing off. Bye-bye.